Today we'll discuss what is nutrition therapy of gut, what foods should we take and what foods should be avoided to relieve the gut symptoms, and what lifestyle modifications should be made to prevent from the gut symptoms. This is Dietitian Fahim Musfar, the founder of dietinmedics.com. Subscribe and share our channel to get continuous updates on our upcoming lectures on evidence-based nutrition. So the first step is we have to remove the triggers that can worsen the gut symptoms. We'll exclude all citrus fruits and juices from our diet, tomatoes, onion, and garlic. We'll exclude caffeine from our diet, like coffee and tea. We'll exclude processed foods, like all fast foods, packaged foods, for these are high in fat and salt. We'll exclude refined grains, like dairy products, white rice, white chapati, white bread. All these foods can worsen the pain during gut, especially when our esophagus is already in inflamed condition. So we'll exclude all these foods. We'll take small meals than large meals. When we take large meals, abdominal pressure increases, as we discussed in our previous lecture, that gastric reflex occur when the abdominal pressure increases. So when we take large meals, abdominal pressure will increase, and as a result, gastric reflex, movement of gastric content into esophagus will also increase and gut symptoms will increase. So we'll take small meals than large meals. We'll avoid from alcoholic beverages, as alcoholic beverages can increase gastric acid production and as a result gut symptoms will increase. We'll avoid from carbonated beverages. Carbonated beverages can increase gastric distension and it also lead to increase in relaxation of LES sphincter, that is the lower esophageal sphincter, and it prevents from backflow of gastric content into esophagus. So when the LES pressure will, when the relaxation of LES will increase, as a result, movement of gastric content into esophagus will also increase. So we'll avoid from carbonated beverages. We'll also avoid from foods that are highly seasonal with chili powder and pepper. So when we take more chili powder and pepper in our diet, then discomfort also increases. So it can cause discomfort. So we'll limit the use of chili powder and pepper. When we chew gum or when we smoke or use straws, in all these activities, we can inhale air in our digestive system. As a result, gastric distension can increase in our digestive system, abdominal pressure will increase, and gut symptoms, the reflux of gastric content into esophagus will also increase. So we'll avoid from all foods, all those things that can trigger the gut symptoms, like we'll exclude citrus fruits and juices, tomatoes, onion, and garlic. We'll exclude caffeine from our diet. We'll exclude processed foods and refined grains from our diet, as these foods can worsen the pain, especially when the esophagus is in inflamed condition. We'll exclude all carbonated beverages and alcoholic beverages from our diet. We'll take small meals, then large meals, and we'll not take foods that are highly seasoned with chili powder and pepper. And the last one, we'll not chew gums, avoid from smoking, and we'll also not use straws. So we'll remove all these things that can trigger the gut symptoms. Second step, we'll avoid from foods. We'll take foods that can relieve the gut symptoms. Like we'll take fresh juice, fresh vegetable. In meat, we can take lean meat, like chicken can be taken, fish can be taken. We can also take bone broth, as bone broth is one of the best therapeutic food that can heal the esophagus, that can heal the inflamed esophagus. In fat, we'll take healthy fats like olive oil. In fruits, we'll take apples, pears, and berries. And we'll also take yogurt, as yogurt is a probiotic and can improve the digestive health. So we'll take all these foods that can relieve the gut symptoms, and along with this, we'll also take peppermint. Peppermint, according to research, peppermint can decrease the pressure on lower esophageal sphincter. So as a result, gastric content movement, gastric content reflux will also decrease. and gut symptoms will also decrease. So we will take paper mulch. Research showed that when we take more water, the patients with the GERD, when they take more water, GERD symptoms decrease. Papaya and ginger tea is one of the best therapeutic food in GERD because both these also aid in digestion. Papaya contains enzymes papain, as papain aids in digestion. Apple cider vinegar. Apple cider vinegar research showed that when you take apple cider vinegar 10 minutes before meal, it also reduces the GERD symptoms. And when we take 1 tablespoon of apple cider vinegar in a cup of water, that also reduces the GERD symptoms, especially when we take 10 minutes before meal as it aids in digestion. So the third step is lifestyle modifications. In lifestyle modifications, we will decrease our body weight. If we are overweight or obese, we'll decrease the body weight. As we discussed in previous lecture, that in the obese or overweight patients, abdominal pressure increases. When the abdominal pressure will increase, gastric reflux will also increase. So we'll decrease the body weight. We'll elevate the head to bed by 6 to 7 inches, especially in those patients in whom GERD symptoms appear at night. Take 2 to 3 hours. Eat meal, consume meal 2 to 3 hours before sleep, and remain upright right after the meal. And another thing, wear loose fitting clothes. And when we wear tight fitting clothes, the abdominal pressure can increase, pressure on abdomen can increase, and as a result, GERD symptoms can also increase. So we should wear loose fitting clothes. The last one, manage stress. When you take exercise, the stress, your level can be decreased. So in the stress condition, GERD symptoms increase. So just take exercise, your stress will be relieved and your GERD symptoms will also be decreased. So what lifestyle modifications should be made? Just if you are overweight or obese, reduce your body weight, elevate head to bed by 6 to 7 inches, especially in those patients in whom GERD symptoms appear at night. Just eat meal, consume meal 2 to 3 hours before sleep. Remain upright right after the meal. Wear loose fitting clothes and manage stress. So if you like our video, don't forget to subscribe and share our channel. And if you have any question, feel free to ask me in the comment section. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.